Okay, so you just got a brand new DJI FPV quad. This is the GEPRC Mark 5. I love this quad. I have the original version of it that has an original air unit. This has the O3 air unit in it, which is stabilized. It has built-in image stabilization. The camera's a little bit better. The footage actually looks pretty good and smooth without a GoPro or anything on top of it. So that's why I want to try this guy out. I am going to set this up and show you how to do it and how to avoid some pitfalls. So let me take you through a quick list of things you probably should have in order to do this process so you don't have to go get it, you have it all with you. First of all, you need the quad. And depending on the quad, you may or may not have easy access to the ports, the USB-C ports, one on the O3 unit and one on the flight controller. So if you don't have easy access to it, you might need something like a wow stick or a Allen wrench in order to get parts apart so that you can get the cable into it. But this guy, fortunately, the Mark 5, has easy access. It's got a little break here in the side and you're able to get right inside to the O3 unit, as well as on the other side, you can get right into the flight controller right there with your USB-C. So I don't think I'm gonna need the wow stick for this, but good to have it nonetheless. You should have a battery, charged battery ideally, for the quad because you're gonna have to turn it on. And to that point, these things get very hot when they're sitting idle and they're on. So I have a fan right here. This is a Honeywell. You can get different kinds, but this one points straight upward. It's pretty quiet, and I like to set the quad on top of it while it's running and let the airflow go across it so that it doesn't overheat and go into standby mode. You'll want your controller. Now, in some cases, you might have a different controller, but this is just the DJI FPV controller, and it is actually DJI FPV controller 2. It is designed to work with the O3 units natively. So if you've got a bind and fly, I'm just gonna actually bind this directly to the O3 unit, and that's gonna be my receiver in here. I don't need another receiver. If you have something like a Crossfire or an ELRS or some other protocol, FR Sky receiver, you'll have to put that in. That's a separate deal. I'm not gonna talk about that today. I'm just gonna talk about binding directly with a native DJI thing that speaks directly to the O3 unit on its own. The next thing you'll need is your goggles with a battery. So make sure you have these ready to go and charged. These are the goggles 2. If you have the goggles V2, they will also work in a very similar fashion. So don't worry about it if you have the V2 goggles or the goggles 2. They are two different things, even though one is the V2 and one is the goggles 2. If you have the goggles V1, they're not gonna work with it. And so you won't wanna try and bind all this together with an O3 unit and the goggles 1, but they will work with the goggles 2 and the V2. And then you need a battery, of course, for the goggles and the cable, which I have right here. And then of course, you will need a cable to connect the quad to your computer. And on your computer, you're gonna need two pieces of software. You're gonna need DJI Assistant for FPV, and you're gonna need the latest version of Betaflight, or a version of Betaflight, so that you can set up all your controls. And keep in mind, we're gonna try this here in a second. This is a newer Mac, and this uses USB-C only. It only has USB-C ports. Sometimes when you plug USB-C out of the computer into a device with a USB-C port, it doesn't see it. It doesn't work for some reason. I don't know if that's because the cable is not a data cable. This actually is a data cable, so if it will work from USB-C to USB-C, this cable should work. But in some cases, if it doesn't, the easiest thing to do is just get a USB-C to USB-A connector. USB-A is the old square or rectangular one that converts it to USB-C. And then that allows you to actually plug this end, the USB-A end, into the USB-A end of your converter. Plug this end into your quad and this end into your computer, and that almost always works. So that shouldn't be a problem. But we're gonna try it both ways and see if I can go USB-C to USB-C. So hopefully that's not too confusing, but just know if your cable's not seeing your air unit for some reason, that's probably the problem, is that you should get the old school USB-A cable and an adapter and use that instead. So all of that said, we're gonna give this a shot here. The first thing we need to do is go ahead and open up DJI Assistant. Okay, so it can get a little bit confusing because DJI has different versions of the Assistant. You can see here, this is DJI Assistant 2 DJI FPV series. That's what you would use if this was an older air unit, But with the new Air unit, you actually want to use the consumer series. So I just selected that, and it's DJI Assistant 2 consumer series. So now we're going to try plugging in the quad, and we're going to plug it into the O3 unit, not into the flight controller. The O3 unit is the device that actually transmits the video to your goggles, records the video in this case, and also acts as a receiver in this case. Now, I'm going to try it with the USB-C to USB-C cable. Like I said, it can take about 10 seconds. And then sometimes also, like in this case, I plug the battery in. Yeah, there it goes. Okay, so DJI 3 O3 Air Unit shows up. Double click on that. And then it's going to ask you if you want to activate it and also upgrade it. So currently this is on release version 1.0000, 1.1.0000. I want it to be on 1.20000, so I'm gonna hit upgrade. Go ahead and say start upgrade, and then it's gonna do its thing. And this is where you wanna make sure you have a steady internet connection. So it's updating the firmware right now. One other thing is make sure that your USB-C to USB-C cable is a high-speed data cable, not just power, because I think some of them are just power and some of them are lower speeds. This is a high-speed data cable. All right, well, I thought I was gonna have to actually activate this O3 unit, unless, of course, DJI Assistant is already logged into my account and it somehow did that in the background, but it may ask you to put in your DJI account email address and password. Not a big deal if you have to do that, but it hasn't asked me to do that yet, so we'll just go with it and see what happens. So now that I've activated the Air unit, I can go ahead and bind the quad to my goggles first, and you always want to start with the goggles, because I think if you start with the controller and then you do the goggles, it unbinds the goggles. Now what we're going to do is go ahead and bind this with the goggles and with the controller. These are the goggles 2, not the goggles V2, but the goggles 2. The Integra goggles are basically the same thing as these, and so if you have the Integra goggles, it shouldn't be any different other than your battery will be internal and not external. So what you do to get the bind on these is you just press this little button right up here. You hear that beeping noise, and then you come over to your Air unit and you need a toothpick, or in this case I have a small staple that I've bent, and there is a little tiny red light. I don't know if you can you see that red light? There's a little tiny red light, and the button for binding I believe is right below that. It's recessed, and you'll feel it give way, and now it stopped beeping. And now I should be able to see the goggles. One other note on, or I should be able to see the camera. Yep, I'm seeing a live view from the camera. One other important thing before you go to bind your goggles, make sure they're in O3 mode, not Avada mode or DJI original Air unit mode. There are probably 3 different modes they can be in, and you'll wanna make sure they're in O3 mode, not original Air or Avada mode. All right, so the goggles are now bound. Now what I'm gonna do is go ahead and bind the controller. So I'm just gonna leave the goggles right over here. I think you can just leave them on, or you can turn them off, it doesn't matter. But the way you do this, turn on your controller, and to start your controller into bind mode, you just hold down the power button for like 5 seconds, and it'll start beeping. So now it's in bind mode. You see these little lights go, that means it's in bind mode. Now I'm gonna plug my battery back into the quad. And I'm gonna find my staple again. And I'm going to go down here and find that little button again, which like I said is right below the green light. It's a little hard to get a hold of because, where is that guy? Starts blinking. It's bound. The light on here is green and this stopped blinking. So if you don't care about how your switches are set up, then you should be able to actually go out and fly it now. Because right now, the switch that is normally switching me to manual, sport, or normal mode is my arm switch. I like to put my arm switch the same place as the Avada on the stop start, and you can do all that in Betaflight. So let's do that now, if you want to change the settings. Otherwise, if you're good with whatever the defaults were, switching between modes and between switches, then you can just stop and go out and fly. So to do this, I'm going to put this thing back on the fan because it's still plugged in and it's still getting hot. And I'm going to properly this time plug it into the flight controller, not the air unit. So the flight controller is in front. The USB-C for the flight controller is on the opposite side of the air unit, or as it is on the air unit. So that should give you at least some idea of where it is. And I'm gonna open up Betaflight. And when I do, hopefully, the quad will show up. Now, it's not showing up. Let me hit connect and see if it does. It's not. Failed to open a serial port. This may be a case where you actually do need the little dongle instead of this cable. I don't know why this is, but this usually fixes the issue. So I'm gonna use my USB-C to USB-A, plug in my USB-A into that, and then plug the USB-C end into the flight controller. And hit connect, and voila, there's my quad. You can see it on the screen. It's reacting to how I'm moving this thing. Now that I've got the quad showing up, bound, and again, it's sitting here on this fan, so it's not overheating, which is great. Let's see, I'm gonna go into configuration. If you wanna rename your quad, so this is called the Mark V. I could call this the RSD Speedy. Yeah, let's call it RSD Speedy. And save and reboot. That will change the name. You'll hear that noise. And now I'm gonna go into receiver. And I'm gonna just check to make sure that my receiver's working. And you can see that when I push throttle, it's throttling. When I roll, it's rolling. When I pitch, it's pitching. When I yaw, it's yawing. So that's all good. So what I wanna change is the switches to where we arm it, and also to where we change between modes, and also to activate the beeper. So you go to modes right here, and you can see right now the arm is on aux one. So I actually want, I wanna change my aux 1 to be where I switch between angle and normal and manual mode. So for angle, I want the switch up. So I'm gonna drag these two little bars over, and now I'm in normal. And if I want to be in horizon, or what might be called sport mode, I change this, because it says horizon over here, to aux 1, and now you can see I can go to manual, horizon, or angle. And so if it's outside of these two ranges, it's in manual, and that's what I want. So now for arming, I want the arm to be this button here. So I need to figure out what this button is. Let's see, is it aux 6? No. Is it aux 5? No. Is it aux 4? Yes, it's aux 4. So the start-stop button is aux 4, so basically I want it to be armed in one position and disarmed in the other. So now you can see that little yellow dot right there is jumping between disarmed and armed, because when it's in the range, it'll be armed, and when it's out of the range, it'll be disarmed. And then finally, I'm not sure what user 1 means, but I want to go and unclick this hide unused mode so we can see other things. So the beeper, I want the beeper to be, I guess I can make the beeper this one here. So figure out which one this is. Is this aux 3? No. Is this aux two? Yes, it is. So the beeper is gonna be all the way down. So if I push it all the way down, you'll see it's in the yellow here, and that means the beeper is gonna go on. And if I push it up, then the beeper won't go on, or in the middle it won't go on. But all the way down, I'm gonna get the beeper. And I think that's everything I need. I don't think this thing has a GPS unit, but if it did, you could actually go to failsafe here and add a failsafe, meaning return to home. This one doesn't have a GPS. Before you do anything else though, you wanna hit save. Save. That should be it. We should be able to disconnect. And now if I unplug this, I should be able to arm it by going, yeah. So now it's arming with my stop-start switch. The rates are changing with this. Oh no, the beeper's changing with this. The rates are changing with this. And that's everything that I have set up on it. Should be ready to fly. Hope this was useful. Leave a comment below and let me know what you think. And I'll look forward to seeing you next time on Ready, Set, Drone. Thanks for watching.